Let's start question number 17 now. Women still lag much behind men in India despite some improvements since independence. Analyze the statement. So we'll analyze why women are still lagging behind men. In India, women still lag much behind men despite some improvements since independence. Some of the reasons. The first point, patriarchal society. Indian society is still a male-dominated society. Women face disadvantage, discrimination and oppression in many ways. The second point, literacy rates. The literacy rate among women is only 64.6% compared with 80.9% among men. Similarly, a smaller proportion of girl students go for higher studies. Another reason why women lag behind. Third point, low paid jobs. The proportion of women among the highly paid and valued jobs is still very small. Women are paid less than men even when both do exactly the same work. Fourth point, low sex ratio. Parents in India prefer to have sons. They also find ways to abort the girl child before she is born. Such sex selective abortion has resulted in a decline in female child sex ratio. Another burning issue in India. Fifth point, political representation. In India, women representation in legislature has been very low. For example, the percentage of elected women members in Lok Sabha has never reached the 10% of its total strength before 2009 Lok Sabha elections. In the state assemblies, their share is less than 5%. So students, in this question, you've seen 5 points, but you need to mention only 3 points because it is a 3-marker. I hope that's clear to you all. Now let's move on to the next question, question number 18. Now we will discuss question number 18. Describe the importance of formal sources of credit in the economic development. Let's see, importance of formal sources of credit. The formal sources of credit include loan from banks and cooperatives. Formal sources of credit are less risky and charge less rate of interest. Very important point. Third point, RBI supervises the functioning of formal sources of loans. RBI, that is the Reserve Bank of India. Fourth point, RBI ensures that loans are given not only to the profit-making businessmen and traders, but also to these small cultivators, small-scale industries, small borrowers, etc. Here again, you need to mention only 3 points. Okay. Fifth point says, formal sector loans help reduce dependence on informal sources of credit. It also prevents the borrowers from falling into a debt trap. So students, you saw here 5 points which mentioned how the formal sector loans are becoming very important, which highlighted their importance. You need to mention here only 3 points which are more than enough for answering a 3-marker question. Now let's see which question is given in the choice here. Describe the bad effects of informal sources of credit on the borrowers. Bad effects of informal sources of credit. Higher interest rates on loan is charged. Second point, no organization is there to supervise its lending activities. Just as there is RBI to supervise the activities of formal sources of credit, there is no such organization that can supervise the functioning of informal sources of credit. The third point, since informal lenders charge higher interest rates, the cost to the borrower becomes much higher. That leads to less income. And thus the borrowers tend to find themselves in a debt trap. So students, you can see here how informal sources of credit can bring a misery to the borrowers. I hope that's clear to all of you. Now let's move on to next question, question number 19.